effectively targeting anti-poverty programs in Indonesia. A comparison study between three methods of beneficiary targeting: social assistance programs, such as cash transfers and food assistance, are an important part of poverty alleviation. However, did you know that correctly identifying who should receive assistance is not as straightforward as it seems? Especially in lower-income countries, it is hard to identify who the poorest households are, since a large portion of individuals work in the informal sectors where verifiable income records are lacking. Using unreliable information to decide who should receive assistance can result in resources being diverted away from those most in need. In other words, people experiencing poverty can get excluded, and middle or high-income families may benefit. This is why researchers conducted a study to understand which method of identifying low-income households is most effective.
Between 2009 and 2019, governments from around the world doubled spending on social assistance programs. This was also evident in Indonesia, where the government expanded the social protection programs over the past two decades. However, identifying program beneficiaries in Indonesia was challenging. Take the case of the Unconditional Cash Transfer Program, or Bantuan Langsung Tunai, BLT, as an example. The World Bank estimated that 45% of the funds for BLT were incorrectly provided to middle or upper income households, and 47% of people experiencing poverty were excluded from the beneficiary list. Many people also voiced dissatisfaction with the programs. For this reason, over 2,000 village officials refused to participate in the program. Given the vast amount of money spent on social assistance programs and their importance as a lifeline for poor families, it is imperative to ensure that these programs deliver on their intended goals. Research has shown that optimal targeting could improve citizens' welfare gain from social assistance programs by as much as 57%.
With the goal to improve the effectiveness of social assistance targeting, the government of Indonesia worked together with JPL researchers to conduct two evaluations. The first evaluation took place from 2008 to 2009. Researchers randomly assigned 640 sub-villages across North Sumatra, South Sulawesi, and Central Java to receive a one-time cash transfer of 30,000 rupiah, equivalent to about $3 through two different methods. First, a proxy means test, in which a household's welfare status is predicted using information on their observable assets, such as their house size or ownership of a vehicle. And second, community-based targeting, where community members come together to collectively rank households based on their welfare status from wealthiest to poorest. A follow-up evaluation took place from 2010 to 2012 under Indonesia's Family Hope Program, PKH. Here, 400 villages across Lampung, South Sumatra, and Central Java provinces were randomly assigned to receive the PKH program either through automatic proxy means testing or through self-targeting, in which individuals are invited to apply for an assistance program.
Across the two studies, researchers compared the three targeting methods. The evaluation showed interesting results. First, there is a trade-off between the proxy mean test and community targeting. While the proxy mean test was slightly better at correctly identifying low-income households, the community targeting method led to higher community satisfaction because the household ranking better matched the community's perceptions of which families should benefit from the program. One concern with the community targeting is that it could lead to elite capture, or resources being diverted to those with more high-level connection within the community. The evaluation found no evidence of this. Second, self-targeting is more effective at selecting eligible beneficiaries than the proxy mean test. Households living in extreme poverty or the bottom 5% of the population are more likely to apply for the program, and hence receive the benefits. It is also because those who identify as higher income rightly assume that they are not eligible and refrain from registering. Taking this into account, it is worthwhile to consider combining all of these targeting methods in order to obtain better accuracy. Community and self-targeting methods help address exclusion error by targeting poor households that have not yet been included as potential beneficiaries. NPMT helps in verifying their eligibility. Another important thing to consider is the cost-effectiveness of targeting. Research suggests that targeting leads to a better distribution of beneficiaries at a lower cost. Looking at the significance of targeting, it is very important both for researchers and governments to continuously improve targeting method.
This evidence from randomized evaluations provide important insights on how to effectively identify the poorest households that need assistance and make sure resources are correctly distributed. Fast forward to 2020, the result of this evaluation was adopted by the Ministry of Village and the COVID-19 Relief Program, which used the community targeting method to provide cash transfer to over 8 million recipients previously unenrolled and social assistance programs. Learn more about J-PAL Southeast Asia at www.povertyactionlab.org/SEA.